In the name of the Father, of the Son, of the
Amen.
Holy
Father,
Spirit,
Son, Holy
Amen.
Spirit. Amen. Come, Holy Spirit, fill the hearts of your faithful and enkindle in them the fire of your divine love. Send forth your Spirit, and they shall be created, and you shall renew the face of the earth. O God, who by the light of the Holy Spirit did instruct the hearts of the faithful, grant us by the same Holy Spirit to relish what is right and just, and always to rejoice in His consolation. Through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Okay. From the Holy Gospel according to Saint Mark.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Peter began to say to Jesus, "We have given up everything and followed you." Jesus said, "Amen, I say to you, there is no one who has given up house or brothers or sisters or mother or father or children or lands for my sake and for the sake of the gospel who will not receive 100 times more now in this present age. Houses and brothers and sisters and mothers and children and lands with persecution and eternal life in the age to come. But many that are first will be last, and the last will be first." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Tita Lynn.
The 3 pointers for today's Gospel. Number one. Peter asked Jesus what he and the apostles could expect to gain from having left everything to follow him, because Jesus had told the rich man the day before to sell all he owned to follow Jesus. Number two, instead of rebuking Peter, Jesus assured him that his reward will be both here on earth as well as in heaven. Those of us who serve others out of love for the Lord know very well the truth of Jesus' promises. Number three, what have you left behind so as to be able to follow Jesus more closely? What do you find most difficult to let go in your life? Pray for the grace of detachment in anything that prevents you from being attached to living and serving the Lord more wholeheartedly. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Thank you very much, Tita. Thank you very much, Tita Linda. No, ang the third pointer is so another challenge, challenging, great challenge for us. No, na what have you left behind? What is it in our life that we can let go just to follow Jesus? Yun ang ibig sabihin. What are those precious things or whatever, no, in our life na pwede natin i-let go? Ano kaya yun? Yun, mga very, very challenging, another very, very challenging words of Jesus, no? When he said that, come and follow me. Today's gospel is related to yesterday's gospel, di ba? Yesterday's gospel, yeah, is about the rich young man.
Rich man.
Oo, the rich man. Oo. And then ito is about Peter na what more. Kumbaga, instead of Peter, pwede din tayo maka-ask kay Jesus, no? What more can I do? Lord, what more can I do for you? Yun. Pero we have to be ready kung ano. What is it in our life that we can let go or we can surrender, no, na i-let go natin just to follow him. So that's the message of today's gospel. Tita Bell, we have another very nice reflections from Catholic mom.
Yeah. From Catholic mom. Our family just experienced the painful loss of an unborn baby. It cuts us all to the core because this baby had been so desired for such a long time, and its parents are very devout, faithful Catholics have given up much to follow the Lord. The entire family grieved deeply. Parents, grandparents, aunts and uncles. And this gospel passage spoke to my heart. I felt like yelling at God, "They have given everything to follow you. How could you allow this loss?" Then I reflected on the end of this passage. This is really what happened to me this morning when I had my clinic. I had a patient who desired so much this third pregnancy because her children were already grown-ups, although she was also already in her advanced age. Then she got pregnant. Then the pregnancy didn't progress. The heartbeat disappeared. So the older siblings were already very, very excited to have their baby sister. They were asking for a sister because both are boys. And then they were so anticipating. They were so happy. They were so excited. And all of a sudden, the heartbeat disappeared. I was really at a loss on how to comfort my patient because she was really crying and sobbing this morning. And I was telling her, you know, our plans are not God's plans. We don't know really. At the moment, it's very hard to comprehend why the Lord allowed this to happen when in fact you really desired, you really wanted this baby. But then it's not our will, but His will. We don't really know His plan for us. So I know my words are not enough to console you and your two sons, but let us just accept what God's will is, because it's hurting, more hurting than if we keep on challenging or asking, "Why, Lord? Why, Lord?" So I was struck by this when I read this, because it's almost the same. No? They were good followers of the Lord. They followed the tenets, all the commandments. Then they have this loss, and it's so hurting. So the one who wrote this realized this baby had gone straight from the warmth and love of its mother's womb into the embrace of the Lord. The baby is a saint in heaven who will intercede for all of us. It will never sin, be disappointed, or suffer. It will live in eternity seeing the face of God. Isn't that what we all ultimately desire? Because it's eternal life that we all desire. So this little one, who was the last of our family, has become first in heaven. So nice, no? The last statement, the first will be last, and the last will be first. So he interpreted this, that the baby who died became the first in heaven. And among the sadness there is a great joy and consolation. So nice, no? So nice. But at the moment when we are at our lowest ebb of our lives, we cannot comprehend God's plan for us because we always question, why me?
Why?
Oh. Lord, why did it happen? Why did you allow this to happen? When in fact, I'm a good child of yours. It's usually the statement that will, or the conclusion that will usually arise from sadness. But then God,
we don't have the right to ask
our hearts at best or our lives at best, which we cannot at the moment just comprehend, no, His plans. Amen.
Thank you very much, Tutabel. It's not for us to ask why, because it's true, because our plan is different from God's plan, and just trust him. Amen. Oh, amen. Tito Manch, you have something?
Yeah, I'll read this Das Marinas. Maganda. Reflection.
Always.
It
Always
says,
think.
what
Always
are we
look at.
capable of giving up for Jesus? See, it is a question for us. Can we give up our riches? Can we give up our life of sin, hedonism and worldliness? Perhaps this is quite hard to do for many of us. Well, man or people always think that we own all these things. These things, we acquired all these things with our own intelligence or what. See? Akala natin, sa atin yun, sa ating magawa. Kaya ang hirap pa hiwalayan. Eh, no? We always think that God owes us. Wala tayong may utang sa Diyos. Walang utang na loob ang Diyos sa atin. Tayong may utang na loob. Yun ang maling kaisipan ng tao. We thought na God owes us something. That all, everything we have is ours. Because we deserve it. No, we do not deserve anything. But if we do so and we begin to trust and love Jesus more than this world, we would also see a marked improvement in our lives. There would be less human-created wars, stress, and problems. Yun, tayong gumagawa ng sarili nating problema. Stress. This is for the reason that we've decided to embrace Jesus more than this world. Jesus tells us in the gospel that if we give up this world and choose to follow him, we would receive more than this world could offer. But what does this world offer us except sin? Endless pressure through accumulation of wealth, power, and problems. Hindi tayong gumagawa ng sarili natin problema kasi God owes nothing. And we own nothing. Siguro sa atin, kasalanan lang. Let us try detaching ourselves from this world, even for only a short time, and we would see the big improvement that it would create in our lives. Let us cut out our relationship and communication with our friends who have not brought any good into our lives. Tama. Give up those people who are not loyal, disloyal to you, or giving you problems. See? Give up nothing aside from riches. Because man always think that all these riches comes from our own intelligence, sarili nating sikap. Di natin alam na bigay ng Diyos lahat yung biyaya niya. We own nothing, not even our life. Let us not be afraid to give up this world for Jesus, because there will be enormous rewards that awaits us the moment we decide to give up this world in favor of Jesus. But what are these rewards? Bibigyan pa tayo ng reward. I-give up lang natin. Reward that we do not deserve at all. These rewards, the rewards are peace of mind, contentment, acceptance of things that we cannot change, and so on. Kaya tinanong ni Peter sa ibang gospel, parallel gospel, synoptic gospels not written by Matthew, I think, mas matindi pa ang kwando, ang sinasabi. Ito kay Peter, medyo mild lang. We have given up everything to follow you. Anong para sa amin? Ganon din ba tanong natin sa kay Jesus? Prayer warriors kami, Lord. Ano bang mahihita namin? yung para bagang binibigyan na nga tayo ng biyaya, reklamo pa tayo. Hindi pa tayo kontento. Kaya dito, anybody who give up house, brother, sisters, mother, father, for the sake of the kingdom, of the gospel, will receive 100 times more. Yun ang pangako niya, 100 times more. Hindi siya nagbibiro dito, hindi siya nagsisinungaling dito, totoo ito. These are all true. 100-fold. But many that are first will be last. And the last will be first. Kaya, pag mabagal tayo to give up everything and to follow Him, eh, mahuhuli nga tayo. We will be lost. So, this is also all about being a disciple, follower. Gaya ng yung gospel yesterday. Ang inihingi dito, obedience to the commandments and sharing your riches to the poor. But it doesn't end there. It's now in the gospel for today. Come, follow me. Yun ang pangatlong ihilingin sa'yo. Come, follow me. But you cannot follow him if you have all these baggages. No? You have to give up. Mabigat yung daladalahin mo lahat yan. Kailangan magaang lang. Wala kang daladala. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Thank you very much, Sito Manny. So very true. Do you have something, Tita Kors?
Of course. Parang kumpletong-kumpleto na yung sinabi ni Manny. Tito Manny. Na ano, dadagdagan ko lang yung sinasabi niya na actually dun sa gospel. And that's what struck me, no? Yung sabi ni Jesus na when you give up all of these things, I'm going to give you 100-fold back. Okay? And then, he enumerated. Have you noticed that Jesus, in fact, the Bible doesn't contain any superfluous or unnecessary words. Wala siya. So that means na everything there should be read. Everything there should be understood. Lalo na kung si Jesus mismo ang nagsasalita. Okay? Yung Gospels talaga. So, ang sinabi niya na when you give up mothers, fathers, brothers, sisters, lands, okay, lands. I guess yung lands, ayan yung worldly possessions.
Possessions. No?
That's the representative, okay. Sinabi niya, I'm going to give you 100-fold of these things. But note, may karagdagan sa sinabi. Plus, persecutions. Okay? Last persecutions. Bakit biglang nakasingit yung word na persecution? Si Jesus ito, ha? And because this is Jesus speaking, he's not telling a lie. That's the truth. Na talagang bibigyan niya tayo, yes, na rewards. Pero, meron tayong mga hardships, meron tayong difficulties. We have persecutions. And the reason for that is not because he is punishing us, but because he wants us to spend less time in purgatory by responding to the sufferings and the persecutions in the right manner. That is total surrender to God's will. So, yun, tatanggapin natin ng maluwag sa loob natin ang lahat ng grasya. Magpapasalamat tayo. Pero maluwag sa loob din natin at magpapasalamat din tayo na tumanggap-tanggapin natin ang lahat ng paghihirap, mga sakit-sakit, mga problema. Because the right way, when we accept and we thank God for these tribulations and these sufferings in the right way, the way He intended us to accept them, to receive them, we are preparing our way to heaven. Yun nga daw, walang nakakarating sa heaven na walang pasang-pasang cross. Because the way to heaven follows the way of Jesus, and Jesus is carrying a cross. So tayo na sumusunod sa kanya, hindi pwedeng naghahayunan lang ko sa Bisaya. Dapat may pasan-pasan din tayong cross. So all the way from hanggang doon. Now, ang isa na naanuhan ko, nabasa ko lang naman, si St. Teresa of Lisieux, one of the doctors of the church, ano, very young. Ang sinabi niya, there is nothing really important but love. Okay. And when you love, you are not afraid to empty yourself out for the person that you love. Okay. And figuratively speaking, when you empty something, that thing becomes what? Zero. Wala na. Wala na laman. So zero siya. Zero. So it's the same thing with people. When people really give up everything, okay? People give up everything, in the eyes of the world, you become a nobody. Sa worldly sense, you become a nobody. Parang zero ka. Hindi ka nakikita, hindi ka napapansin, wala kang value. But this is the thing, Saint Therese said, but the numeral zero has no value. But note that if you put it at the right of one, it gets multiplied by 10. Diba? Zero. Ilagay mo sa tabi ng 1, magiging 10. Okay? And dinugtungan. That is why if we are zero, we have to make sure that we are putting ourselves at the right of the correct one. Kasi kung ilagay natin ang sarili natin sa right ng hindi maganda, mamumultiply ang kasamaan 10 times. But if we put ourselves sa right ni Jesus, then whatever good we make, whatever good intentions we have in our heart, they get multiplied by at least 10.
At least 10. Yes. Ang sabi ni Jesus is 100 times.
Yes.
Oo. Yeah.
So yun ang sinasabi ni St. Teres na ano. So yung namang giving up the world. Okay. Hindi naman kasi literal yun, no? Yung mga parents, yung mga brothers and sisters, hindi literal. Ang sabi ng isang homilist, how do we make this practical? How do we make this applicable to our daily life? Na ganun. Kasi sabi na, imposible mag-iwanan mo asawa mo. Basta na lang decide ka iwanan kita. Okay, gagawa ako ng trabaho sa simbahan. Hindi naman pwedeng iwanan mo yung mga anak mo dahil nagagawa ka ng trabaho sa simbahan. So, ang sabi ng homilist ay, little by little, we can think of, depriving ourselves of something that we really like, okay? Or the reverse of that is different, na we make time. Usually, ang time is very expensive for us, eh, di ba? Parang kulang tayo sa time. Kulang na kulang sa time for everything, for a lot of things that we still want to do, okay? And one of the first things that suffer pag kulang tayo sa time ay ano? Prayer time. Yun ang nagsasuffer. Pag kulang tayo sa time, hindi na natin matapos yung ating night prayers, nakatulog na sa sobrang pagod. Okay? So, ayan siguro, sabi ng homilist, that's where we can start. Give up things. Because hindi sufficient. It's not sufficient that we give up things. Dapat, we give up things because we intend to follow Christ. I-give up na natin ang dessert, pero ang gusto lang naman natin ay para pumaya tayo, then wala rin namang ano yun. Wala rin merito, kumbaga. So, yun. If we give up something that we like because we want to create that space sa schedule natin para makadasal man lang kahit isang decade ng Holy Rosary, that has value. That is following Christ. Yun ang sabi niya. And I like that one better. Kasi parang magagamit natin siya sa araw-araw. Amen.
Amen. Thank you very much, Cor. Na nabasa ko yan noon din na empty your basket so that Jesus can put something in your empty basket. Oh, yun ang sabi. So, thank you very much. So, any other piece of your thought? So maybe that's it for today's prayer meeting. Thank you very much for the sharing. Thank you very much for the insight and our reflections, no? And let's move forward, really.
Let me add something to that, no?
Oh, yes, no, sure.
What Tita Cora said, anything that hinders us, that hinders our in following Jesus, should be given up. Anything. Like when you enter the seminary or become a priest, you have to give up. Your families. Yan sinasabi dito, children, parents. Okay? So you can concentrate. Okay? Kaya nga may vow of celibacy para walang istorbo yung pamilya pag later on. Kaya may yung celibacy na yan. Vow of celibacy. Okay? Kasi pag may pamilya ka nga naman, sa gabal yun, sa mission mo. Now, you have to... We can never out-generous God. 100-fold. See? We cannot out-generous God.
Amen.
Amen.
Thank you very much, Tito Manny. So that's it. And thank you very much. Thank you very much, Tito Mans, for your insight, Tita Cors.
You're welcome.
And Tita Linda for the three pointers, no? And let's just remember, no, na today's gospel, no, is kumbaga give and take or exchange gift. exchange gift yan. Yeah, we give something, and then we have something in something in return. So we give something, sacrifice everything, sacrifice mga challenges in life, trials, service, love, compassion, forgiveness, no? Ang something na ma-receive natin is eternal life. That is for sure. Amen.
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 Meron na ako idadagdag, pwede?
Yeah. Huh?
Just one more. This is from St. Anthony Mary Claret. Okay, and I'll read. Our Lord has created persons for all states in life. So, kanya-kanya tayong states sa life. And in all of them, we see people who achieved sanctity by fulfilling their obligations well. Okay, so that means that we have to do the best that we can in whatever state of life God has put us in. Provided we do it for love of God. Kasi hindi naman tayo pwede lahat na ano. So kung saan tayo nakalagay, we do the best that we can there. Ang sinasabi ko sa mga estudyante ko, just before they leave for the last time sa classrooms ko, try to be good in doing good wherever you find yourself in. So, ganyan din ang ating dapat gawin. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Yeah, thank you very much. Thank you very much. And now for the closing prayer.
Yes. Lord, we pray you grow in us a passion for people, especially for those who don't know you yet. Create in us a heart that longs for others to know the same grace and mercy that you have shown us. May we be a living, breathing testimony to the goodness of who you are. In Jesus' name, amen.
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 And all together, please, let us pray. Glory be to the Father,
glory be to the Father,
the Son, to the Holy Spirit,
to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Thank you all. Thank you very much. Good night. Good morning.
Good night.
Love you guys. Good night.